It's Big Game Burger Day, and I'm not talking about Ohio State versus Pitt, Brent.
Today, we're making elk burgers. Today, we're working with an elk shoulder from our friends at Fossil Farms.
If you're looking for a sustainable farmed elk, you're gonna be looking at Canada, and Fossil Farms brings it on down. Brent, you wanna open this up? We can get a look at this lean, mean elk machine.
Let's do it. Oh yeah, oh yeah.
The chuck is actually pretty ideal for making a burger from any animal, but especially a lean animal like an elk is even more important. As you can see, we have a lot of connective tissue here, which we'll need to trim. You don't want that sinew in there, but you also get globs of fat, which when making a burger, you need fat. Brent, you told me to take it easy, so I'm gonna do that. Would you mind trimming all the sinew off of this?
I'll do the work.
Okay, so while Brent is doing the trim work here, and he's doing a great job.
Hey, thanks.
It's worth noting that the anatomy of any of these animals is going to be very similar. So this looks a lot like a chuck from a beef or a pork. It's just different of size and scale and fat. Overall, we're gonna be taking the same approach to this as we would a beef shoulder.
So anytime I have a little piece of fat, I do wanna save this for the burger blend, because elk is still a very lean animal. It's only 6% body fat, where, I don't know, take something like Ben, is probably closer to 20% body fat.
So we have, for a burger blend, we have the short ribs.
I mean, we have the bavette over here.
Got a little bit of skirt right here.
And a whole bunch of belly flap.
And we're just gonna cut right along that line and take this part and use this for our burgers.
We're just gonna cut this into 1-inch cubes.
So ideally when we're making beef burgers, we like 70% lean to 30% fat. Obviously with elk, we're not gonna get that. So where do you think we're gonna end up?
I mean, I think we want to play into the fact that elk is a leaner meat. So we only want 10 to 15% fat.
And if you wanted to add more fat, you could go to a local butcher and get pork fat or beef fat really, really cheap. And pork fat won't affect the flavor too much. Beef fat is gonna affect the flavor a little bit, but we really want this to be an all elk enterprise. So we're gonna stick to what we got.
Ben, it is time to grind our meat.
Ooh.
Carry that on the subway?
It's not the weirdest thing I brought in the subway even this week. How many grinds do we want to do?
I'm not sure. We usually do 2 passes with beef so that the fat is evenly distributed. But I think we just start with 1. See what we're looking at.
Yeah, man. Why let's just take it easy.
This is a new adventure.
Let's let the elk guide us into what kind of burger it wants to be.
All right.
This has been chilling for, that got cold quick. This has just been chilling for about 15 minutes in the freezer?
15.
We wanna get this to be as solid of a piece as possible. It'll go through this, so we'll have more intact muscle and fat structure. Also, it won't smear as much because we wanna keep the entire process of grinding as cold as we can. Here we go. It's another day on the grinder.
This is looking pretty good. You have seen us use ice before when we made a sausage, but burger grinds, keep your ice out of there. Put that ice back in your margarita, bud. What are you thinking here, Ben?
I kind of think it's good as is. What do you think?
I think she is gorgeous.
Our fat looks pretty evenly mixed, but with only 1 grind, we're still gonna get like real steaky bite out of it.
So if we're making a big patty, we're talking 6 to 8 ounces, which means it's gonna be a larger grind in order for it to be steaky.
Even though we have like a decent amount of fat because we were using the belly and the short ribs, you wanna stick closer to rare. You're gonna get more flavor. It tends to dry out a lot quicker because there isn't any fat.
All right, we're ready to make our burger patties. We're gonna make 8-ounce burgers because Ben needs to put on a couple pounds. From our grind here, again, you see us always mixing things. We're making sausage, we're not making burgers. Now we're making burgers. We're not mixing anything. Don't mix it, you're not making a meatball.
Don't be a hero. Don't be a meatball hero. We wanna keep it loose. We want that sticky bite. We want that sticky texture. That's why we're gonna keep it really loose.
Wowie zowie. We got our burgers formed, they are chilling out, and we need to get the rest of our ingredients ready. So we're gonna make a horseradish mayo. Ben, better get to grating that horseradish.
So if you have a peeler at home, you can use that to peel the skin off of the horseradish, but we are gonna use a chef's knife today. Brent, would you say horseradish is overrated or underrated? And how do you like it?
I feel like it's so underrated, I don't even want to talk about it on camera because it is one of my favorite secret ingredients.
Really?
Oh man, put it in everything.
Are you joshing me right now?
No Josh, bro. No Josh, straight up. So the horseradish is gonna add a nice pop of brightness to the mayo. It's gonna help cut through a lot of the big flavors from the elk. We got our quarter cup of horseradish. We're ready to make our mayo. First, we are going to start with one egg, boop, 2 teaspoons of Dijon, 1 quarter cup horseradish. All right, so we're just gonna pulse our first 3 ingredients to incorporate them. They're incorporated. We're gonna slowly add our oil. Looks nice and thick. We're gonna thin it out just a little bit with a touch of pickle juice.
This will affect the amount of salt you want to add because obviously brine, pretty salty. So you'll just salt it to taste.
You notice we haven't added any salt yet. Let's give it a taste.
Okay, definitely need to add more salt.
Let's taste it for salt.
Boop-a-doop.
That's great. That really did bring out a lot of the horseradish. I do think it could use a little bit more, just because I like mine a spicy.
Okay.
Also, if you don't have fresh horseradish, you can use prepared horseradish. It's okay. It comes packed in water, so your liquid is going to be a little bit higher just from your emulsification, so maybe don't use it till the end, and you can use it just in the last bit of seasoning. We're back in burger universe. All right, we got a big beefy burger. We got our acids that are gonna cut through that.
Mm-hmm.
What aspect are we missing?
My guy, we are missing the cheese.
It's a cheeseburger after all.
It's a cheeseburger.
What do you got, Ben?
We have a very special cheese today. One of our favorites from Southwest Virginia, from Meadow Creek Farm, Grayson cheese. So this right here is a soft cow's milk cheese. If you ever go to, you know, the supermarket and you get a soft cheese and you're like, wow, that is a funky, pungent smell. This is in that family. This is our last way that we're gonna add more fat to our burger. When we're talking about big game burgers that are gonna be kind of lean, cheese is a great way to get some fat incorporated, and nothing's fattier than my baby right here from Meadow Creek.
It's your favorite time of every episode, Ben. Time to cut the cheese! Woo!
Look at that. Okay, we have our mayo, we have our cheese, we have our onions, our pickles, everything to go on the burger. What's missing here?
We just need our burger patty. Let's get a cast iron pan, get her nice and hot, get cooking. Just to stay consistent with our 100% elk burger, we rendered out some elk fat, and we're actually gonna fry the burger in the elk fat. The great thing about kidney fats as well is that they have a really high smoke point. So like beef kidney fat, you can deep fry in. Elk, same thing. So it's actually gonna be a really great fat for frying a burger.
Brent, let's drop some buns. Woo, that is hot. This will only take a few seconds to get these buns nice and brown. I feel like you have strong opinions about how much you want to salt a burger.
I don't have strong opinions. There's just a right way and a wrong way, and the right way is my way, which means a lot of freaking salt. To say liberal would be an understatement. You want
copious?
Copious.
Would that be the statement?
I think that would be a correct statement.
And remember, you're just salting the outside, but you're trying to season something to go all the way through. So it might seem like a lot, but it's not. Plus, some of the salt is going to fall off the burger. It's not like you can stack an inch worth of salt on a burger and it'll stay there.
Also, you'll notice that because we did just one grind, this is a really loose pack. That's gonna help us get that real big steaky texture we're looking for.
Burgers, 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 burgers.
Are you sure you're ready?
Burgers, okay. Burgers.
Once you put them down, let them sear, let them hang out. You know, when we're grilling steaks, we wanna turn them a bunch of times. The cast iron pan, burger, you wanna make sure that that sear is consistent, which means a hot pan. Put it down, don't touch it. Because we're working with elk today, we wanna make sure that we're not cooking to all the way to like medium, medium well. We wanna keep it on the rare side. This is lean meat. We don't have a ton of fat that we're rendering.
We need to keep it on the lower temp side. So we're looking for 120, 125 as the internal temperature.
Perfect.
To help your cheese melt a little bit more quickly, you can add a little bit of water just to the pan. Throw on a lid really quick like we're about to do, and it'll help that cheese melt a little bit quicker. That's good. Yeah. You gonna pull them?
Yeah.
All right.
That's a,
is a melt
burger.
Yeah. Nay. That is gonna be beautiful. This one seems like a diet burger by comparison. Okay, there we go. We have these burgers cooked. We are ready. We're gonna build this burger as quickly as we can because I'm hungry. Brent, what's first?
All right, mayo first. Need to hit both the bottom and the top.
All right, next up.
Burger.
Oh, so that is a good 10 or 11 ounces with all that cheese on it. Next, we have some red onion. Pickles. All right. Guys, this is it. We started by saying it was big game burger day, and we were not joking. I can't remember the last time I made a burger this big.
No, this is ridiculous, and I'm very excited about it.
But it was all about starting with the animal, which we knew would be lean, and then building around the natural flavor we would be getting from that, and how can we make that flavor even bigger and more beautiful.
Whoa, I know Fieri said it first, but holy flavor town.
Yeah.
Every aspect of this works well together. The brioche bun.
The horseradish mayo.
The onions.
The pickles.
The elk.
The fat that we cooked the elk in.
I know, the whole thing is absolutely ridiculous.
The cheese.
Oh yeah, and the cheese. Big game burgers, big game flavors. This whole thing is crazy and super delicious.
Incredibly good. If you have any questions about this big game burger or want to tell us about your big game burgers you make at home, drop us in the comments.
Thank God.
About time. It's time. I need this. Oh, that's how you wash it down.
Now it's a burger.
Beer also pairs well with elk burgers.
See you on the hunt.